Now that you've had a chance to recuperate and you've seen the Hall of Fame presentation, and I tell you, it was an honor for me to be a part of it, me to be able to present it to you, how does it feel to be our second recipient of the Hall of Fame Award from the UCWDC?
I don't think I've ever caught my breath yet. It's absolutely stuns you. It floors you. You can't breathe. You can't talk. You can't think. It's kind of stupefying. And I'm slowly. It's been about an hour and a half now. I'm slowly coming back to myself. And I think it's the most wonderful thing that's ever happened to me.
When Mike Haley says that he can't talk, I'm impressed. It's never happened before. Hey, there's nobody else more deserving than you for the Hall of Fame Award. Congratulations, Mike.
Thank you, Scott. I appreciate it very much.
Before we begin our presentation this evening, I'd like to give special thanks to Mr. Brian Milhouse of Spotlight Productions. Brian has put countless hours in preparing for this presentation tonight of the Hall of Fame Award. Brian was up literally all night long last night. He did not sleep 1 minute last night putting this presentation together for you this evening. He will be back at his booth immediately following this presentation if you've been looking for him. Please, once again, show your appreciation to Mr. Brian Milhouse of Spotlight Productions. The Hall of Fame is the most prestigious award presented by the UCWDC. Each year, council members are asked to nominate an individual, couple, group, or team who exemplifies a truly dynamic spirit, a person of admiration, and one who is worthy of this exemplary honor. This award is bestowed upon someone who has contributed in ways which have changed or advanced the path of country dance as we know it today. Someone who has achieved success, yet is willing to share their gift of knowledge and talent with others. The Hall of Fame recipient is carefully selected from a field of rare visionaries who have impacted our world of country dance by broadening horizons and breaking new ground. This young award is only 2 years since its conception. In 1995, last year in Disneyland, our first Hall of Fame Award was presented to Mr. Dakota Dave Getty. Dave, come on out. Our 1995 recipient. If you cannot see the screen, you may want to find a way to see this screen. You can see it in the back, but if you're on the side, you may find a way to see this screen. Once again, the 1996 UCWDC Hall of Fame Award recipient.
I always thought you were the best. I guess I always will. I always felt that we were blessed. And I feel that way still. Sometimes we took the hard road, but we always saw it through. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be you. Sometimes the world was on our side. Sometimes it wasn't fair. Sometimes it gave a helping hand. Sometimes we didn't care. 'Cause when we were together, it made the dream come true. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be you. Someone who understands me, knows me inside out, and helps keep me together, and believes without a doubt that I could move a mountain for someone to tell it to. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be one friend left, I'd want it to be you. Someone who understands me and knows me inside out and helps keep me together and believes without a doubt that I could move a mountain. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be you.
If we can have the lights, please allow me to introduce to you the 1996 Hall of Fame Award winner, Mr. Michael Haley. Surprised? Good. Mike started dancing when he was 11 years old and soon began teaching at the young age of 14. By my calculations, that means he's been teaching for approximately 104 years. He began his competitive career in the ballroom community at age of 15. He was soon the owner of his very own studio at the young age of 18. At age 18, Mike went to London, and he was the youngest person at that time in history to achieve certification as an instructor of the international style within the ballroom community. Following his return to the United States, Mike spent 4 months as a performer at the MGM Grand on the Las Vegas Strip. After that successful stint, he returned to his current residence in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and opened another dance studio. His studio was a tremendous success for offering ballroom, jazz, tap, and ballet. When country western dancing became the rage after the release of The Urban Cowboy, Mike began offering country western dance lessons at his studio. They were a huge hit. He later organized the New Mexico Country Kickers, a pioneer country western dance team, and among the first synchronized dance groups in the country. Mike's work with them was an early influence on the development and direction of team dancing as we know it today. while dancing on the kickers and doing choreography for the country kickers, he began judging and coaching competitive couples. And in 1987, he met Patty Miller. And thus began his successful competitive career within country dance today. Right from the start, it was easy to see that they were a unique dance couple with energy and elegance prevailing. After only 4 months, after 4 months of entering their first competition, they placed in the top five. Within 6 months, they achieved their first sweep and their third of 14 consecutive first place waltz championships. During this time, Mike, with the help of Steve Stevens and Patty Miller, began one of the finest UCWDC events on the calendar, the New Mexico Dance Fiesta, now in its eighth year. As if running his own dance event was not enough, Mike was a pioneer by taking on the tremendous task of event director of Worlds One right here in Nashville, Tennessee. He is a man of many hats. He is a top-notch coach, an innovative choreographer, a spectacular performer, an impartial judge, and most of all, a man of great wisdom. Mike, to all of us, you have never failed to share your ideas, and through your generosity, others have realized their dreams within the world of dance. Your stride for perfection, through elegance and grace, will leave dancing changed for the better forever. Many dancers continue to strive for the standards you've continually set for years. Mike Haley, you are an inspiring man with insight for future potential. And tonight we recognize your unique ability to locate the path which turns visions into reality. On behalf of all of the directors of the UCWDC and all of the dancers around the world and in this room, we welcome you to the United Country Western Dance Council's Hall of Fame. Mr. Michael Haley. Are you ready?
For what?
I'm going to try.
You can do this.
I don't know if I can do it or not. I just want to thank everyone. Country Western has changed my life. I have more fun, I have more friends. My life is full. Thank you.
Once again, the Hall of Fame for 1996, Mr. Michael Haley.
Hey, Mike. How you doing, buddy? Yeah, that's good.
Have to read anything?
No. No, what happened was a lot of people this weekend took it upon themselves to do our little game in the program, Name That Logo Contest, and I have all of the forms that were filled out absolutely correctly, and so we might as well leave it to our Hall of Fame winner to pick the winner. Names are on here, so Hold this. Want to talk some more?
No.
Maybe sing a little?
No. I just want a jacket like yours. His costume designer used to be my costume designer, but...
Some people get the Hall of Fame award, and some people have great clothes.
It's true. The older people have great clothes. I think I've recovered. I'm not sure.